Welcome to Could You Survive? Today's challenge, cobras. Those hooded beauties have a reputation that precedes them, a reputation built on a potent venom that can send shivers down the spine of even the bravest explorer. So the question begs to be asked, could you survive a cobra bite? So let's get rolling. First, understanding your opponent is the key. Cobras, with their diverse family spanning spitted cobras to the monstrous king cobra, come in various flavors. I mean various subspecies. All, however, possess a potent neurotoxic venom delivered through their fangs. When a cobra strikes you, the initial pain might feel mild, but the real danger lies in what happens to your body. Cobra venom disrupts your nervous system, muscles, and even heart, potentially leading to paralysis, breathing difficulties, and even organ failure. This isn't a regular snake in the backyard. So, you gotta take that cobra seriously. But fear not, Explorer. Surviving a cobra bite is possible with the primal life secrets, like staying calm and acting fast. Forget the Hollywood myths of venom sucking or Rambo-esque tourniquets. These stunts only look good in movies. In reality, they can do more harm than good. Instead, here's your survival mantra. Immobilize the bitten limb and seek medical help immediately. The sooner you reach medical professionals and receive the life-saving anti-venom, the better your chances of escaping unharmed from this encounter. Now, let's imagine a practical situation. What if you're miles away from civilization with no medical help in sight? And this is what happens usually. You can be in a remote region on a mountain trail. You can't even expect the ambulance to reach those places there. It's a dire situation, but remember, remaining calm and hydrated is crucial. Every minute counts. So slow the venom spread by keeping the bitten limb cool and elevated. It's not ideal, but it could buy you precious time until you reach help. The venom from a cobra bite causes symptoms such as impaired vision, dizziness, and intense perspiration within minutes. These early symptoms indicate that the venom has entered your system and is beginning to take impact. As time passes, these symptoms may develop and can be followed by other problems such as trouble in breathing, muscle weakness, and a rapid heartbeat. After you get to the hospital, medical personnel will examine the severity of the bite and provide the proper anti-venom. They usually inject the anti-venom, which works by neutralizing the effects of cobra venom, so it minimizes tissue damage and prevents respiratory paralysis. Remember, timing is the key, because the venom can quickly move through the body and cause serious systemic damage. Preventing a cobra bite begins with understanding their nature. Cobras are shy snakes who only bite if they feel threatened. It is critical to respect their space and prevent any activities that could provoke them. These gorgeous creatures have an essential role in ecology, and it's our job to coexist peacefully with them. So here is the final verdict. You may die from the cobra bite, but that possibility depends on the breed and size of the cobra. If it is adult Indian cobra, then you only have 30 minutes to get that anti-venom. If it is a young Naja Oxyana, then you have plenty of time to finish your trek and visit the hospital. And there you have it, folks. If you found this info useful, then like this video, comment down what you want to see next, and subscribe to our channel for more such videos. Until next time, stay wild and stay safe.